guys think about bent sounds. And I hope that I hope that you guys can hear it okay. So, golden ratio. What is the golden ratio? Equals 1.681. Then the really interesting fact epilepsy thing, I'm kind of all over the place. If you draw a little circle around the that's what it is. Okay. Let's pretend. Let me get my markers out. Okay. So with the Pepsi thing, I'll get back to that in just a second. So we have much very clearly using the golden ratio. And I think it's pretty interesting that that occurred. So see if I can look up more high def. Damn, the Apple logo looks like that too. Okay. So the Twitter logo. Let's pretend that's a diameter of 0.68. space here. So we'll pretend that diameter is B. And where we're going with this is, let's see if I can do this right. So it's like right here. What we'll find is that the bottom half of that Pepsi logo actually goes right through, right along that circle, and that circle informs what the rest of the logo looks like. And I think the rest is actually just, the other part is just kind of having the circle. It's kind of like looking at the Earth's equator. Start with our is a unit, and then we use that to extrapolate all our other units. And if we continue this pattern, let's continue it with blue. So I'm gonna draw another box, another square, with sides of length 1 unit. And then now here, I'm gonna draw a square underneath this with a side length of 2 units. So there, there. That's roughly 2 units. And now you'll notice that the ratio of this to this, or this to the whole thing, is going to be extrapolated into this is 3 units. So I'm going to draw out 3 units here. 1, 2, 3. Okay. And let's do that. I'm obviously very much guessing at this. Take this, mark that, 2, 3, and 4, then 5. Okay, so far off. That'd be 6, 7, 8. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that will be my line right there. Okay. Side real quick. I'm going to show you how the Twitter logo is made. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Okay. Alright. So, let's see if we can understand this. If I draw square. Okay. So if I draw my little rectangles again to reference, we're gonna pretend that this. Said the ratio of A to B equals the ratio of A plus B to A. So thank you. first curve of the golden spiral, or the Fibonacci sequence. Okay, so this is going to be the Fibonacci sequence based on the golden ratio. The Fibonacci sequence is a series in which the pattern of each number is the sum. It's the sum of the previous two numbers. So we start at 0 or 1. If we say 1, then the next number would be the sum of the previous two numbers, which is 0 and 1, which is 1. Now the next sum is going to be the sum. The next number is the sum of the previous two. 1 and 1 is 2. And then that's why that's 2 units. Next one is 3, because 1 and 2, the previous two, is this one and this one. That makes a length of 3. Then this one is the previous 2, which is 2 plus 3, which is 5. And 3 plus 5 is 8. In this little spiral that we draw. So by adding the arc in each square, you'll end up with a diagram of the golden spiral. And I started my spiral. My square was, this one was the wrong one. You're supposed to start in this one. But, here we go. Just draw it. Let me draw this first. Okay, so we're gonna just touch the borders of each one here. So this actually appears. Maybe I'll think to maybe I'll add a picture right here of ferns, flowers, seashells. You can just, the list goes on. Snail shells, obviously. And we have hurricanes, Milky Way galaxy. So, we have our little circles. Now, we've been beaten over the head with a theory. We can apply it. So, let's look at the Twitter logo. Oh, the Twitter logo. I would have to expand it out to one more side that long. But let's just... start there. Is that going to be acceptable? Yeah, that's good enough. We'll start there. Okay. So we got our little one. We're going to go over here. Duplicate that. 1 plus 0 is 1. Now 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay. 1 plus 1 is 2. So that will be that. Okay, and then 8 plus 13 though this. The architect, this thing would have crumbled long, long ago. And, nice. Okay. But, yeah, that really, I didn't really plan that out super well, I guess. The ratio of A plus B to A, which equals 1.681, is apparently the ratio of the height to the where the roof starts to pitch. That could be considered A. I definitely didn't draw this accurately, but this would be B, and it forms the perfect ratio, 1.681. I think something that's really interesting is that the pyramid of Giza is holding a little secret. So, if we go directly down to the, if we were at the peak of the pyramid, we went directly down and measured that, that would have a length, if we say, just say 1.681, and this right here guys will know. And if we pretend, despite my drawing, that this is a right angle, then this right triangle right here would have a side of 1. Such a cool symbol. And the pyramid, the whole pyramid sign would be 2 units. If V is 1.681, you could create a perfect scale of the Giza pyramid. So, it's, I think it's really fascinating that thousands and thousands and thousands of years ago, well, at least 3 or 4 thousand, maybe 5, I guess, so fascinating that something is so well understood yet so misunderstood and so enigmatic creates galaxies. And structures like sunflowers. You to sleep. So I'm gonna let you guys go with I'll see you next time. Get some sleep. Bye.